New normal or not, for people who have lost someone to the virus, grief and healing are particularly hard during a pandemic. One of the victims of the virus was Nashville's first female bus driver, who had a huge impact on her family and community. News Channel 5's Erin Cantrell tells her story.
More than 500,000 Americans have died from COVID-19 complications, and one Nashville family wants you to remember, this virus does not discriminate.
Driving a bus may look intimidating. It was the opposite feeling for Elizabeth Duff.
She just liked driving. You know, driving a big bus around, it's fun, and it is. It's actually fun to do.
The 72-year-old went from being told as a little girl she couldn't ride in the front of the bus due to segregation to taking the head seat of the bus in the 70s.
Sometimes I wondered if she really realized her accomplishment that she made for the women in Nashville.
Elizabeth was Nashville's first ever female bus driver, a major accomplishment she remained very modest about.
She would tell them that she worked for MTA and that she worked there for 30-some years, and that was it.
Sadly, the mother of three died last month due to complications of COVID-19.
I lost a wife, a companion, and my best friend.
On Friday, the Duff family held a visitation for her, taking time to say goodbye and remember the good times, like when her oldest son, Harry Duff Jr., brought over sweet pastries.
I would deliberately break them pies and cakes and donuts just to see that look on her face. It was so genuine and beautiful.
Harry and Liz were married 55 years, and processing the grief of losing her will take time. Alive's Grief Center director Allie Dresser says that's normal and the Duff family isn't alone.
People are in a higher level of distress.
Dresser says it's best to let the grief out.
That person is going to live with their grief the rest of their life. And if they don't learn effective ways to manage it.
Harry struggles with the fact he survived COVID and his wife didn't. But he's never going to stop sharing the legacy she left behind. Reporting in Nashville, Erin Cantrell, News Channel 5.